Well, first of all, it's a real honour to be elected leader tonight, and I really appreciate the support I've had on that. We've got a very exciting future in Thurrock, many challenges to overcome at the same time. Biggest regeneration area in the Thames Gateway, but great opportunity coming from that to actually really get some great investment into Thurrock with new schools and job opportunities, etc. Again, with the authority itself, working hard to keep the improvement programme going. I think we've come a long way in the first 5 years. We've just had the best ever education results at GCSE in Thurrock, which has been fantastic. Social care is doing very, very well and been commended by the CSKY Audit Commission recently, which has been great. Good things happening, clean and greening, moving forward. Recycling has gone over 30%. We've got a new recycling centre coming in West Thurrock for people in the west of the borough, so investment in that. Investment in our schools going forward. We just actually got through the first stage of a bid to refurbish or rebuild a number of our secondary schools, which is fantastic news as well. So obviously the FEHE campus coming to Grays, the temporary building's already open. So education, top priority, investment in that, keep improving standards, cleaning and greening and the environment, top priority, the challenges around climate change, working very hard to reduce energy consumption in the borough, showing leadership on that. Greening issues, streets being cleaned and improved, many areas, but good progress made, but challenges ahead all in those areas really.
What do you think your biggest challenge is going to be in the coming year?
Well, I think as we know, there's very tough times ahead in terms of the economy. We know that government spending will be squeezed going forward. Whichever government is in power after next year, that's going to come right down to local authorities. The pressure will be on to get much more for less money, and that's a big challenge. Trying to keep a balanced budget, trying to keep the commitments on keeping council tax as low as we can, but at the same time delivering an improving council that's delivering great services for residents. So that's the real challenge, I think. Very tough times ahead with the economy, but possibly people are saying we may be seeing the turn of that shortly, but certainly the government has brought a lot of money to get through, and obviously that will be coming down the tracks now and less money obviously available to do things, and we've got a lot to do, so we've got to find better ways, more efficient ways of doing our business going forward.
Okay, John, it's been an interesting year in council this year. What can you look forward to in the following year?
I think before we get to that, I need to congratulate both Maureen Pearce on being elected as the Mayor of Thurrock. I know that she'll do a fantastic job. And Gary Haig on being elected as Leader of the Council. Gary has an interesting year, as you said, ahead of him, with lots and lots of challenges. I just hope that Gary proves to be up to the job. But the evidence of tonight would suggest that he won't be. He doesn't seem to realise the scale of the problems that are facing the borough. Seems to be in complete denial. So, for instance, I've heard him tonight say that environmental services in Thurrock are getting better. Actually, the Audit Commission, the independent arbiter of these services, says quite clearly that they're getting worse. Our star rating for environmental services has gone from 3 to 2. And that's replicated in other areas, such as the benefits service, which has gone backwards, the housing service, which has gone backwards, adult social care, which has gone backwards under this administration, seeing the closure of homes, and the imposition for the first time of charges for the services that the elderly in the borough need. We've heard about the good things that are happening in education. I'm the first to agree with that. GCSE results are the best that we've ever had. But 5 years ago, there wasn't a single school in Thurrock in any Ofsted category. There is now a list of them. That is a demonstration that the council is not properly looking after schools in this borough.
What about working together in the future? I noticed that you didn't get anywhere tonight in the voting. It was very 26-23. That must be a disappointment.
No, on a personal level, it's not a disappointment at all. It's exactly what I expected. You expect the East Tilbury Independent Conservatives to vote with the Conservative group, as they have done consistently. The Vice Chair of the Planning Committee, you expect him to vote with the people who put him there. So no, not personal disappointment at all. I think there is disappointment, though, for those people in the community who need some good, clear leadership from the local authority and need to believe that the local authority is on their side, not against them. And I'm afraid that this administration administration has consistently proven that they are not on the side of people. This is the administration that wishes to impose car parking charges on communities that have never paid and to increase the charges for others by 50%. They all had the opportunity to vote against that. None of them took the chance to. We've had a statement from the leader saying that he intends to scrap that. We've seen no evidence of that being scrapped yet. As I've said before, this is the administration that sought to impose care charges on the elderly and vulnerable for the first time and have since increased those charges. This is the administration that were only stopped from scrapping police community support officers by the campaign that was launched by the Labour Party and by the residents and community of Thurrock.
I think our challenges are to be an extremely organised opposition. So we are holding the administration to account so we can actually see what's going on and be ready to challenge it at every time. You know, at the end of the day, hopefully all politics is local, and actually what we want is the best for our constituents, and that's what we're elected for, and that's what we need to do.
The Audit Commission was very critical of the Council on its recent commission, particularly of communication. Do you think that was a fair criticism?
Oh, most definitely, yes. I think it's something that needs to be learnt. There is very little cross-party working going on. It's clear that there is only one administration here that actually don't want to do anything with the opposition. You know, together we could be quite a formidable force to actually try and drag Thurrock back to where we need to be. But sadly, you know, you could see that clearly tonight. You know, an administration that was prepared to do some cross-party working would have offered at least a couple of chairs of scrutiny, or if not, some vice chairs. Clearly, we were given nothing.
The voting tonight, 26-23, was that very much expected?
Oh, for goodness sake, yes. I mean, we only had to see the recent BNPs launching their manifesto as evidence of the, you know, the BNP Tory alliance. You know, it's clear when you look at it, the Tories are basically endorsing the BNP's manifesto by allowing them to launch it in council property. You know, it's outrageous. So I think it is quite clear, you know, I mean, we knew where the voting was going to be, but it's up to us to challenge, and it was right that we actually put candidates up.
John Kent seems a very forceful leader. Do you think he could make a serious challenge at the next...
John Kent would make a superb leader of this council. He would actually get us back to where we'd need to be. And, you know, believe me, it wouldn't be easy. We have budget challenges and, you know, no one's saying that it's an easy ride. But he has a very disciplined, a very group that is focused and fully supportive of their leader, which is something I don't think the current administration
can say. Well, I think obviously the Audit Commission did pick up on some issues around how the council is run or runs itself, certainly around relationships between officers and members. We've got an improvement board running that's working really hard to try to deal with that, and that's cross-party now, so working together to try to get those relationships working so the council functions properly. That's really important, and a big focus on that. Also, the financial management of the council needs to be improved as well. These are things around the sort of how the council is managed. But in terms of what's happening out there, what residents see, you know, the feedback we have is that they're happy with, you know, the improvements that are being made. Long way to go yet, very long way to go yet. But those things we do in terms of improving how the council operates will actually help us to turn it from a two-star authority towards a four-star, and that's what we're aiming for. Across the council, and that's what I'll be leading as the leader, working with all members and the management team and officers to turn this into a top performing authority itself, getting efficiency and value for money, and obviously making sure we don't lose sight of the services we provide. But lots of utility coming. We're going to, you know, keeping our weekly recycling. Many authorities have gone away from that. We're continuing to support the police, the PCSOs. And again, as I said in my speech this evening, you know, we actually support the police in Essex more than any other local authority, the PCSOs. So that's really positive. So things that the residents see, we're not letting up on those. We want to improve those. It will be tighter with the financial pressures that we all know about, and also turning the authority itself in terms of its performance from a two-star into a four-star. So it's a massive agenda, but, you know, the whole team's up for it. We've got a new cabinet that's really energised, really ready to go, and we'll be working, you know, cross-party in the council to get everybody on board, harness everybody's support, and really, you know, do the best for the people of Thurrock. That's what it's all about.